All right, so today, with the importers and exporters all done in fancy new registration mechanism, I need to work on moving the bringup data, state data, out of the main repository, because it really shouldn't be part of it, as well as changing up the loading of said data, said state, into a more flexible pattern or a more flexible to be loaded dynamically, because right now it's hard coded right now, and that's just no good. So I need to update that, as well as this can probably stay, but the point is move this to a more dynamic system right now, make loading of state more dynamic. So the first thing I'm going to do, let's see, first of all, I've got test export sitting way down here. So it looks kind of all right. So still want to have it something in like data, but rather I should have a new folder. It'd be like, let's call it like bringup. Bringup data. Bringup state data. Something like that. We'll put both persistent and the data A into that soon. I'm also going to probably have to finish up. Like, there's something wrong with this, if I recall. I don't remember what. It's probably exporting something which it shouldn't be. And I'll have to fix that up. As well as fixing up the export to also do like a comparison between the original data and the current data. Yeah. Okay. So to start with, I'm just going to... That'll be a new Git repository. That'll be like a Git submodule, so I can actually keep, like, if there's any binary data, I mean, there's got to be binary data in here somewhere. External, like these FBX files, not necessarily the I mean, these are text files, that's easy enough for Git, but these binary files, I don't want to accidentally start committing more and more into the original engine repo. It shouldn't be that way. The data is going to be kept separate. Like an optional import. But before we hit that, really I need to be able to change where it's loading data from, which means I need to change this. Now, let me have a look. Where do I load settings? I load settings from here. So, what I'm thinking of is settings, have it load, like not just settings, I mean, what's this? These are actual settings. These aren't really things I want to change up too much. But what I do want to do is like have a standard string, like a path. Realistically, settings should allow me to add search paths as well as the data I'm going to try loading. Now, I'm not sure if I want to save the search paths. Search paths I may want to save. Okay, so I need to add this to that. So we got settings. Search paths. We're going to have that. And that can be like that. Okay, we can add it as setting it here as well. We'll just have it like under general, or just like, because we have Windows, we have Windows stuff, we have graphics, we have XR. So if I double check what's going on in settings, Windows stuff, in the window, yeah, the window node. If we have width of 1920 and height of 1080, that should be just fine, right? That should now encompass a quarter of the screen, because this is a 4K. That's a lot of stuff being recompiled. Not great. But I'll live with it. F5. Debug it. Where is, oh. It did not take effect. So my settings are broken, is what you're telling me. Great. What's going on? Config file. Config items are overwritten by command line items. Okay, that makes sense. Let's go here. What do we got? Oh, these two. Great. Which actually makes sense, right? Command line options are ones you want to override the file. The file is more permanent. So if you want to make modifications, you do it on the command. Yeah, now it's 1080p. Yeah, okay. But wait, we do the command line parsing first, so that way we can find the config file. And if we have out config file as well. Yeah, we've determined the config file, then we parse the config file, then we re-overwrite with anything that was set by the config file with command line options. Again, so we just re-parse this twice. I guess, what is this? This is just the try-catch, so we do that twice. Okay. Let's add in the command line options. All right. So you have a thing for search paths. So these are paths that we're going to search. We have, I don't know, where am I right now? Data. We're going to go in here. This is the directory one we want to add at first. So this is the search path we're adding. Like that. XR, window, graphics set. So we'll put like general stuff. Non-specific at the end, I guess. Search pads. And what is this? How do I do a string? Validation, bool, logging, vsync, height, with height. Okay, I'm going to assume that it just turns into a string. Is there a way? Can I add like a function? Add complex. Okay, let me bring out the documentation for, was it CLI 11 parser? Okay. This looks more like it. Complex is for that. So add option function type, where type is standard string. That's what we pass in. Okay. So we got search path. We add it here. This is like a global thing. So P options. Sorry, where am I? Down here? Nope. Here. Include those search paths. That. That adds it here. We go in. Add the command line options. We do that. Okay, we also need to add it here in the application. So this kind of has to go up before this stuff. So we got after the search paths though, and we need to pass in search paths. Okay, going into search paths again. This should be fine. Okay. Add, what was it? Option function. This is the name of dash dash search path, with the function being, takes in a standard string, so. Takes it in by reference, got that, standard string, constand, strong. We got the function, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, like that. Option description is that the for data sets. Option data, I guess. We're going to go with search. How do I do it? I go writer dot search path, I'll push back whatever the string is. The writer gets released when it leaves automatically. Right? And what's wrong here? I have string, yeah. That works. But that doesn't. Okay. Alright, let's see if this works. So what I want to do is I just want to try to add data state. I already have that actually, don't I? Right there. So let's see if that actually works, shall we? Do 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 do. I don't really mind if it's added more than once. I'm thinking, what if I just add these two, then run the CL parse, then run the config file, then add these command line options, then rerun the parse, so I don't accidentally add it twice. But first of all, let's see if it adds it once, actually. I need to add it to the data to actually be run. Stop the run, stop it. So engine here, args, there we go. So we'll do data search path, comma, this. That. Okay. The answer is a no. I just never even reached this point. Interesting. Okay. Okay. We failed to parse stuff. Horrible. Horrible, horrible, horrible. It's because of this, right? Okay. And if I do add it, what do you do? Is it expecting const char star, maybe. Parse. Go into there. Yeah. Go in to there. Validate configure. Go into here. Just keep going deeper and deeper. What order okay, so hold on. Yeah, okay. Maybe I just. Okay. Okay, so I'm in here. I'm getting the writer. That's great. Search paths. M-sync. Yeah, yeah. There's a reader. There's several readers. Why? What? Back to the application. I already have a writer. That actually may be a big problem. I can't get a writer if although I don't know why I would just do that. Okay, search paths. That's a path, data state. What? Interesting. I am intrigued as to why it. Yeah, okay. I'm supposed to give it the data. Not the old hard-coded string. No paths. Now there will be a path. It'll be this. Then the data state. Great. Then it'll be added a second time, which is not what I'm looking for. Okay, what if I have dash help? So what if I just call foe engine what comes out? Segfault, great. Big problem. All of that. So that's why I'm doing the all of the options at first, is to deal with the help case. But what if I can just kind of Okay, what if I try this? If I can isolate this, the particular case, so it'll be CL parser. Go to this. We have a little E, which is saying, hey, you know, I got a CLI error for call for help. Okay, if E dot, what, E dot what? What's the last one? You don't get name. Okay, that's what I can work with. If e dot get name equals then we do this. Otherwise we continue to parse the other one after we do all of this. Add this to the non-specific set. Put these up above. So we want to do an add option to function standard string. Okay, let's see how this works. We have, it was a call for, not equal call for help, then exit, otherwise we carry on to this point. and the options, then we do this. Then we get spit out the help stuff. Okay. What? I need to properly return saying, hey, you know, there was a call for help or something. Technically, I do need to return a zero. And I really want to do it right here. Config on exit will be written to this file. Okay, returning. How do I do this? Can I do like an error code? I don't really have. I don't really have a good way to come out of this. Okay. What if I just do bool? Have a bool. Or just do this again. Can I return two things? Actually, let's try to return two things. First of all, we'll have like a boolean that says continue or not, and then the error code or the exit code. That'll not great, but not terrible either. Include people. Okay, we'll go with that. Now we may actually want to just auto that here like that instead. Makes a bit more sense. Okay, return. False and that. then it doesn't matter what it is, but we're going to return true, false in that. Yeah. So if we do have, back out to here, we'll have two things. We'll have continue run, then we want to do basically the same thing, I imagine. Initialize, we need to return two things, maybe return an error code. Like how does this work? It just returns that. You know, I'd be fine with that. I'm going to modify the application and return those two. So we'll have not really settled on that. I'll at least return that. That's great. Then we got a whole bunch of little problems through here. See, do I have end program anywhere else? No, it's just here. What about this? This is everywhere. Okay, then we have end program tuple. Okay, what's going on here? What's the differences? XRes, because, okay, I see. Okay, the main application. Where's main? There it is. Okay. That should just about work, except for, yeah, I didn't swap them out yet, have I? I need to add tuple to all of the cases here, which are failing. So there, 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 there. What's it called? XR. So it's basically XR and program tuple like this. There, there. There, there. This is actually a VK. And so is this one. Tuple. What's it, general, right? Yeah. General fatal. But no. Tuple. No, okay. right, so with that out of the way, now if I go to dash help like that, it's just gonna basically quit right here with a zero though. Continue run, false, return value zero. Just deinitializes but fails to do so because of something. Because I'm trying to I don't have a set yet to deinitialize, so you know. Yeah, bit by bit. I need to add it to retrieving it from the config file now. That was half the entire point of this. At least with the help stuff coming out. So that's good. Specific, so we can go through like if YAML. Okay, if writer. Which I don't currently have. Get rid of these ands and just turn them into. No, leave them. Great, and we'll see where iter. do this. We throw foyaml exception where the see how this works, if at all. Okay. What if I have it as it's another thing like that? How does this work? Will it do what I expect it to do? Will it fail? So E dot. Search paths. Require node not found to parse a standard string. Okay, well, I have it all coming in from the locations now. So does it actually load the data in? Now that I'm adding it dynamically. Data state persistent. So it's finding those, just fine. Okay. Okay, I'm pretty okay with this part then. So we've updated search paths, return. On the out. Of the settings. Almost an hour on settings. Are you kidding me? Where does the time go? Okay, well, Does settings even have to be in here? Yes, because that's got the this struct. And we want to update the git ignore to ignore these ones. Okay. Ignoring everything now, just running the main application, does it work? Okay, that's all the VR stuff. Not really paying attention to. I exit out. Everything works fine. And then this stuff is just modified. Okay. Get rid of that. Don't need. This is really starting to slim down quite a bit. I like it. Parsing. Okay, we now have those items. So going all the way back up to here, we now have the settings, we have search paths. Now we need to go through and find, do the import state. Now, the reason I'm providing import state the entire data path is because I'm not applying that to, I'm not going through search paths for this. I am providing search paths, but I'm just using it to find the dependency importers. It's like, how does this work? Importer should be one, it should just be like one item. But what if it's local to the current directory? Okay. If I find it, okay, so search and create importer. Of the importer that I'm trying to add, which is specifically the what? That, I guess. What am I looking for? Dependency iterator dot name. So I have a name, which is just a standard string, just the basic. Data set name. Then I have search paths. Is there anything else I really need? At this point, no. Is there? Because create importer is global. So, first of all, from the local working directory. Okay, we try it first from here. to return that. So we got to try new importer reset. Create importer from with current dependency value from the group value. Yeah, I need the group. Is it group value? No, it's just group. Or just group. Otherwise, now we go through each of the search paths. So we need the path reader. You know what? I'll just take the hit and just do it every time I'm inside of one of these. So search paths. .get reader. I see what's going on. I'm trying to match the I'm trying to match a stem. So in case like I have, let's say multiple data sets, I have the data.yaml, let's say a full-fledged that, or if I have the data as a directory, or if the data.bin as a binary file. Like I don't want to necessarily match with the data.yaml specifically. I just want to match the data, which is the stem. And if I have that matching, then I try to create an importer based on that. That's what I'm doing here. That's why I got this little funky business going on up here, which means I need to change this to be a bit more of a funky business down here. So always try the local working directory. I mean, do I want to actually do that? You can add the local directory as a search path. Yeah. So you know what? I think I would rather, much rather go with this. Could just go through the search paths and find it. Okay, what's going on here? Go to dependency found. Yeah, okay. Okay, so that's Okay, so that's... This is a whole lot of... Get the reader on the search paths. Okay. Then we're going to go through the search paths. Through the directory iterator. We're going to find it if we can. Equals dataset name. Is it becoming the group? The path, if importer not equal null pointer, then return. Importer. And just keep going until you return maybe nothing. Because maybe I'll have... I can't exit out on the first one. I'm kind of fine. I may have more than one and only one of the importers available for different types. Yeah. Try it. Okay, so we have that. If we found one, so we're gonna try it. Auto importer equals that. Create importer. We're gonna have the dataset name, which is this. The group. And search paths. If we found it. Add it to that, otherwise then we want to put this out, return false. Okay, that just generates them all. This one will be the one that starts at the top. So what I want to do is create simulation. That's great. Persistent importer becomes this. Just that. We need the name, which is what? Not that. Top level data set. and start the search. Let's start that. Sorry. System error. There we go. We did not find it. Which makes sense because that should not be findable. But we change this to, let's say, persistent. Now it's real. Carry on. Where's going to load? Perfect. That's a lot better. A lot better. Is an application. Let's try another thing as well. On this, if, how would this work? Search and create importer. Can I maybe just create one? So I'm thinking maybe they do give the direct path. I want to have both options open, available. So like, try both. Try direct and then try search path and then So data set, search pad, search and create importer, data set name. So I have like state data still somewhere. State data path in the importers. Yeah, okay. I'm not going to change that then. Not these. And not that. Port state data, that, and that. Either as the full path or what if it's like, the specific file name? Okay, because right now I'm saying persistent, but what if it's like persistent.yaml or something like that? Well, no, if they specified it, then they're going to go straight there. Right? Okay, what if first of all, try before we try this, always try the data set just without the stem. If this exists, which is like what the search path slash data set name. If this directly exists, then go with that. Otherwise, then try this not quite matching thing. Instead. No, if the exact thing matches and exists, try it and then try the other ones. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that makes a bit more sense. Just a bit. Available search paths. Now, do I even really need to have this here? I don't think so. This can be shifted. I do have error codes, though. That's actually another thing I really want to do is I really want to improve their capabilities of the system. But what happens when I get back out? Because that would be the last of the state import that would be specific to the bringup application. And it's otherwise kind of self-contained. So actually, I'm going to do that right now. Faux imex. Include importers. Because I already have. What do I have? I have. No, exporters are different. Exporters are very specific. You know what your exporting is. So you create an instance, an object, and then use that to export. Importers, though, is a bit different. Because it's basically calling into the global system anyways. So, we have this create importer, which realistically we don't even need here, do we? Because this is only called in the import state, right? Oh yeah, this terrible plugin idea. Need to get rid of that. Yep, that's what we're going to do. We're going to have like a faux imex export, and it's going to be returning an auto, and it's going to be like, faux import simulation state. Yeah. Because the importer base already has stuff about the import state, right? Close. Does it actually, like, it just has ECS? It doesn't have simulation state. Does full simulation, what does it include? IMEX. Why does it have IMEX? Importer base for faux group data. Persistent importer. Yeah. Do I just want to keep them separate? Like I can have an importer that can spit out a simulation state on command, perhaps. But that's basically what I have here already, isn't it? But that just creates an individual importer. I'm not exactly sure where to put import state, really. I may just have to leave it here for the moment. And I think I will. Okay, but there is another thing I saw on the way through, and that was what? The VK something. There's a VK something hiding around in here, and it really shouldn't be here. Where are you? You. Why are you here? You are required for material, part of the core, part of the application. Why? Should this not, and the pipeline pool. These should technically be part of the graphics session or the runtime. Probably the session. Session would make more sense. Yeah. So these should actually be internalized into the graphics session to my mind. I mean, what does it even have? The list of fragment descriptors. Okay. And where do we actually use this? I presume I'm initializing it. I don't even initialize it. It just is. And it's passed into the material for use there. That's it. That is completely okay. That is something I'm definitely going to internalize. Into the Vulkan session. So we're going to go to the application. We're going to have this. Okay, for the moment, it will just be like auto returns that. I can turn it into a handle type later. go to session, 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 session. Down here, actually, no, here will be a VK graphics set. So we've got the allocator, we've got the queue family, we've got the descriptor sets, we've got that. We'll add it to the end, actually. Have to do any initialization or deinitialize on it, but I do need session to have this down here. Return that. Okay. Now let's change up resource material loader, which is explicitly bringing it in. We can get it from the session. That goes away there. Okay, where is this? Here. Make it like the first thing. Here. Because why do I have this otherwise? Yeah, getting this other stuff. Okay. That should then mean I no longer require it in the application. I don't need it here either. Okay, then I also don't need it as part of the registrar simulation core. No longer require that, no longer require that. Little. All right, it's all good. I should actually disable that so I don't get annoyed by the slow startup from that. After I figure out why this is breaking. Okay. So, I'm in material loader, I'm here. Is this just like null pointer or something? It's very real. Or is it just collision shape issues? No, it was just that. Okay. Okay. Now, with that little thing down, let's get back to this. So we have bringup state. So data, bringup state data, we'll get in it. This is a new one. What I'm looking for is currently just moving both, just moving these into here. Getting rid of. Data set makes a bit more sense. So, in this case, I should only have to change up this data. So, into that, bring up data set, just rerun the application, have it just not work, or, whoop, ah, crap. Need to recompile from the new location, right? Something like that, maybe not. Yeah, it's fine. So I'll go into data. YAML. Ignore any startups PV. So can I go into, nope, and nope, and nope. Can I not like rescan or something? Okay. Let me find it in the file system and just do it manually. Engine. This should also mean I can just put this stuff anywhere I want to outside. But for the moment, I'll keep it as a submodule because the bringup dataset does make sense to kind of keep a link in to it, even if you don't want to necessarily bring it in every time. So data, this open with new code. Bam, okay. Nope, that. So now I only have 39. What's this? This is just the 1x1, yeah. Okay, let me move this over. Let me create the thing for it. So let's delete that. I'm just going to create the repository for it now. How do I? Project. Leave that as public. Okay, create the project. Oh crap, I created it without using git lfs. Do I want to use git lfs? I probably do. Okay, let's, before I put this up, let's rip it all back out. So all these things, this, this, and this. So actually, where am I? Right. Do that. We're gonna. Let's reopen it in code. Got this stuff. That's great. Okay. Okay. So the idea is here, what's going to happen is changes. We have this. We have all this. We're going to just discard all these. I have the data set nearby, somewhere here, this one from May 2nd, I keep bringing it all up. So we're gonna drop that. 10, we're gonna just drop. It's gone, it's just gone, it's all gone. Then what's going to happen here is that we're going to origin, I'm going to add this to push that up. Okay, great, that's now put up there. So now we go into okay, this is being deleted right now, and we're going to get how do I add a submodule? Mm-hmm. Adding, using, removing, da 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 da. Okay. Data sets. Get. still good. We're still loadable. We can still do a bunch of things, right? Don't tell me there was something else I dropped that I shouldn't have. Damn it! What? I'm in here, great. Search path for data, bring up data set, not quite. Right now it's actually bring up data sets. So that's not really an app, that's not really a coding issue, that was just perfect issue like that. We don't need any of these. Pollution. How does one spell pollution? Yeah, with an O. Anything else in here? There's no, yeah, it's not that. Okay. So now I can work across purposes a little bit more. It'll be a bit more difficult, but I'd rather have the isolation for the engine than not. Now, to do one last thing. Now, I'm not really going to set this as a setting. I'm going to set it as a command line option, which is to say, like, what am I importing specifically? Actually, it's still kind of really tied in because of those. I guess I'll just leave it like that. Leave it like that for tonight. It's about just over 2 hours. So I got a number of minor little things done. I guess I could be okay, happy enough with that for the moment. And I internalized that Vulcan item. Now, yeah, I really need to deal with the loading mechanism. The loaders. I really, really do. All right, cheers.